Welcome to our Women of Worth Fall into Fitness series, where this week's focus is financial fitness. And on today, we're going to talk about how we can take ourselves from being overwhelmed and overburdened in the areas of our finances to knowing how to work smarter and not harder so that we can be financially fit to be able to live the life that God has created for us to have. And that's a life of freedom. So with that being said, I want to give a depiction of what we look like on a day-to-day basis when we are consumed and controlled in the areas of our finances, even though people from the outside may not see it, but many of us are walking around with weights on us. These weights are a representation of what our finances are doing unto us. They are weighing us down, that when we want to operate freely when it comes to giving, when we want to operate freely when it comes to making a difference, when we want to operate freely when it comes to serving or sowing into our future or that business or that breakthrough, we're limited by the weight of our finances that keep us down, that keep us low, that keep us living beneath our means. And today we're going to look at how can we be financially fit so that we don't fall into some of the staggering statistics that are out in the here and now. According to our country, we are literally at an all-time high of $14.96 trillion debt. That debt level is so high that even your children's children's children could not get us out of it. And this is what we're looking like as a country. This is what we're looking like as individuals, as families. We are burdened with the overheads of our life. And if you thought that was staggering, the average American has $90,460 of debt, not per family, not per household, but the average individual American. We are walking around with weights that are limiting us, that has been holding us back, that has been keeping us in a level of bondage to not be able to freely operate when it comes to the area of our finances. And then it affects us in our mental, it affects us in our emotions, it affects us in our relationships, because we are literally overburdened. And many people think the only way to take that burden off is to begin to work harder. So they feel like, if I take on 2, 3, 4, 5 more jobs, that's going to get me to the place where I want to be. But we have to understand that even though that may sound good logically, you got to understand the toll that that begins to take on your mind and even your body, that we were meant to live an advancing life, not a burdened life. And the way that we can begin to make differences is to change the way we think about money, change the way we operate when it comes to our finances, and do something different. What are the differences that we can do? We can make smarter decisions when it comes to overconsuming. We're inside of a time where it's holiday season. We're in Black Friday mode, where many people are spending unnecessarily, which just adds to their debt ceiling, which caused them to further walk around being burdened, not understanding or knowing how they're going to get themselves out of debt. But I come here to encourage you today that you don't have to live weighted down. You don't have to live bound in the area of your finances, but you can live in the financial freedom and liberty that God has given unto you when you understand the power of your decisions, the power of investing, the power of sowing. So let's look at what the Word of God has to say when it comes to the area of our finances. Well, in Deuteronomy 8:18, it says, "But you should remember it is your Lord God that has given you the power to get wealth, that he may establish his covenant that he swore unto your forefathers." So that level of God giving you the power to get wealth is not the power to be burdened down, not the power of working harder and not smarter, but the power to use the gifts, the talents, and abilities inside of you so that it can precede you, and that it will then in exchange bring forth the produce that you thought that you can only get externally, that you thought you can only get from having several more credit cards, that you thought that you could get from having 5 more jobs. But when you understand that the power of increase, it lies on the inside of you, then you will begin to see the Word of God, apply the Word of God, and see the principles from the Word of God take root and manifest in your life. But it doesn't stop there, because then it says in Proverbs 10:22 that the blessings of the Lord does what? It makes one rich and it adds no sorrow. It is time for us to be in the side of the lifestyle and the operation of not being boggled down, not being weighted down in the area of our finances, but to now be financially fit so that we can work smarter and not harder, because there is no sorrow that should be added unto the blessings that God has in store for us. And lastly, I want to give you this scripture, 2 Corinthians 9:10, for it is God who is the one that does what? He provides seeds for the farmer and bread to eat, the same way that he will provide and increase your resources, and then that will produce a great harvest of generosity in you. When you understand that you have the power of seed within you, the power of your seed is your gifts, your talents, and abilities that will make room for you, that will be a solution to meet somebody else's need, that in exchange will bring forth a harvest of increase that will allow you to work smarter and not harder. So with that being said, it is time for you to operate in the freedom that God has given unto you. And it's time for you to do something different. Take off the financial strengths and the weight of your being burdened by your finances, and walk in the full level of freedom and liberty that God has called for you to operate inside of. Are you ready for that? Well, receive it today and walk in the fullness of your financial fitness and freedom.